Time for a brand new segment where we call out America's worst liberal conspiracy theorists. Now, of course, week after week, one of the most egregious offenders has been the Destroy Trump propaganda press. Now, right here on Hannity, we'll continue to shine a bright light on just how deranged the media in this country has become. And this is especially true over at NBC. Now, tonight we start in the minutes following James Comey's much-anticipated testimony. Even Chris Matthews, you know, Mr. Thrill Up His Leg, made this shocking conclusion. Take a look.
The assumption of the critics of the president, of his pursuers, you might say, is that somewhere along the line in the last year, the president had something to do with colluding with the Russians, something to do with the helping hand, encouraging them, feeding their desire to affect the election in some way, some role they played, some conversation he had with Michael Flynn or Paul Manafort or somewhere. And yet what came apart this morning was that theory, because in two regards, the president said, according to the written testimony of Mr. Comey, go ahead and get anybody's satellite to my operation and nail them. And then he also came across what was fascinating. Comey said that basically Flynn wasn't central to the Russian investigation.
Now, while Chris Matthews admits that the Trump-Russia collusion theories have fallen apart, he also references, if you pay close attention, the president's, quote, pursuers who have been pushing all of these ridiculous black helicopter conspiracies. So, who are the so-called pursuers? Well, Matthews, he needs to look no further than his colleague Rachel Maddow on the same network as probably NBC's top conspiracy theorist. For example, remember when Maddow speculated that Venezuelans were protesting on the streets because of Trump's FEC filing? Watch this.
Venezuelans are enraged anew by this brand new FEC filing from the White House. This is a country that should be a rich country, but people have literally been starving in Venezuela. Somehow in the midst of this incredible economic and political crisis in Venezuela, Venezuela's state-run oil company somewhere found $500,000 to donate to the very, very, very inexplicably overfunded Trump inauguration.
All right, wait a minute. I get it. If the dog bites, if the bee stings, if you're feeling sad, it's got to be Donald Trump's fault. It's pretty unbelievable. Now, there was also the time that Maddow theorized that Trump could be a gateway drug for the Ku Klux Klan. Really? Take a look.
A lot of people who I think are critical of Donald Trump generally look at praise like that from somebody like Donald Duke and wonder if he is a gateway drug, if there is something beyond Donald Trump himself that means a much greater transformation of the Republican Party into something that is going to be new to mainstream politics.
And Maddow, fully paranoid, also casually pushed the conspiracy theory that the Trump administration has turned America into a Saddam Hussein-style dictatorship. Really? Is he killing people like Saddam did? Watch this.
We have never thought of ourselves as a country where, like, Uday and Kuse get to be ministers of whatever they want, right? We don't think of ourselves as a ruling family kind of place, but now that's what we are.
Yeah, Uday and Kuse. Now, of course, Maddow has also pushed some pretty bizarre theories about members of the Trump administration, you know, like people like Vice President Pence. Listen to this totally false accusation. NBC News. Watch.
When the vice president-elect first ran for Congress, he ran on a platform that the government should take back all the money it was spending to combat HIV and AIDS, and the government should instead spend that money on curing people from being gay. Mike Pence ran for Congress saying, let's not try to cure AIDS.